Hello dear students, in the last class we discussed what is angle of deviation and what is the formula used to find the angle of deviation when the light ray passes from rarer to denser and the denser to rarer. Now, what is the formula used to find the angle of deviation when the light ray travels from rarer to denser? That is D is equal to I minus R. So, when the light ray passes from rarer to denser, the angle of refraction is less than the angle of incidence. Angle of refraction is less than angle of incidence only when the light ray travels from which medium to which medium? That is from rarer to denser. R to D means here rarer to denser. Then, what is the formula used to find angle of deviation when the light ray travels from denser to rarer? So, when the light ray travels from denser to rarer, then the angle of refraction is greater than angle of incidence. Then what is the angle of deviation? Here R minus of I. R minus of I because R is greater than I. R is greater than I only when the light ray travels from denser to rarer. So, this is the formula used to find the angle of deviation when the light ray travels from rarer to denser. And this is the formula used to find the angle of deviation when the light ray travels from denser to rarer. Now, in today's class, we are going to discuss what is lateral shift. So, lateral shift is the consequence of refraction of light. What do you mean by consequence? Consequence is nothing but effect. Effect of refraction of light. So, lateral shift. So, lateral shift can be represented by Ls. Ls. So, what is Ls here? Ls is nothing but lateral shift. Then, what do you mean by lateral shift? See here. Let us consider this is a rectangular glass lamp. And I will name this rectangular glass lamp, that is ABC. A, B, C and D. Here, when the ray of light incident on the surface AB. So, here the light ray travels from ear to glass. So, this is glass. The surrounding medium of glass is ear. So, glass is surrounding medium will be ear. Okay. So, light ray travels from ear to glass means rarer to denser. Ear is rarer and glass is denser. Then, the light ray travels from which medium to which medium? That is from ear medium to glass medium means rarer to denser. So, at the point of incidence, I will draw the normal. So, this is normal. Now, in the denser medium, the speed of light decreases. Due to decreasing speed of light, the light ray bends towards the normal. Now see, PQ and QR. PQ and QR are the incident ray and refracted ray at the surface AB. In the diagram, PQ and QR are the incident ray and refracted ray at the surface A. Okay. If PQ मतलब QR are the incident ray. So PQ मतलब incident ray अगर QR मतलब now, the angle of incidence that is I and the angle of refraction that is R. This is R. Okay, see here. This QR is incident ray for the second surface. Will you want telescopic refractive surface and consider what happened? Error. Madhul and AB. Next one is DC. Okay. Now, this QR is incident ray for the second refractive surface. The QR another second surface here. Incident ray. Now, at the point of incidence, I will draw the normal. In order to find angle of incidence. If it is an angle R, then this is also angle R by the concept of alternate angles. By the concept of alternate angles. And this QR emerges out from the glass. The QR is from the glass in the horizontal. And the light ray is in the glass to air, means denser to rarer. When the light ray travels from denser to rarer, then the refracted ray bends away from the normal due to increasing speed of light in the rarer ray. When refracted ray bends away from the normal. Now, this is, let us take RS. So, let us take this RS. Now, QR and RS are the incident ray and emergent ray at the surface DC. So, in the diagram, QR and RS are the incident ray. So, first surface is QR refracted ray RS, second surface is QR incident ray. So, QR and RS are the incident ray and emergent ray. So, why the RS is for emergent ray? Because it is emergent from the glass, organ. Okay. So, QR and RS are the incident ray and emergent ray at the surface. At the surface DC respectively. Now, this angle is called angle of emergence. Now, if there is no glass there, or when a glass will not come, this PQ incident, will be passed straight without any deviation. PQ will not be straight and pass up there, rather than a deviation or not. But because of glass, the P2 can be bent towards the normal. Incident ray will be normal but bent. So by what angle it bends from its incident path? That is called angle of deviation. Now see here, this is extended incident ray. We are going to take this extended incident ray only when in the absence of glass. But because of presence of glass, the light bends from its original path. The original path of the light will be bent at that. Glass level. Okay. Now, the angle between the extended incident ray and the refracted ray, that is called angle of deviation. This is D. Angle of deviation is D. Then, what is lateral shift? Lateral shift. So, lateral shift is the perpendicular distance between the extended incident ray and the emergent ray. I will draw the perpendicular distance from extended incident ray to the emergent ray. This perpendicular distance is called lateral shift. This perpendicular distance can be called lateral shift. Then what is lateral shift? It is the perpendicular distance between the extended incident ray and the emergent ray. So let us define the lateral shift. It is the perpendicular distance between extended incident ray and emergent ray. Extended incident ray. Extended incident ray and emergent ray. So now, what is the expression used to predict lateral shift? The lateral shift point of control on formula is what is that formula? So that is expression for lateral shift. Ls is equal to Ls is here lateral shift. Ls is equal to T into sin I minus of R. Sin I minus of R divided by cos R. Divided by cos R. What is T? T is thickness of the slab. And T another is slab thickness. Okay. T is thickness of the slab. And I minus R is nothing but So why we are going to take I minus of R here? Because the light travels from rarer to denser. When the light ray travels from rarer to denser, the angle of deviation can be determined by I minus R. Okay. Now this is the expression using to find the lateral shape. So remember here, what is T? T is thickness of the glass slab. Then I minus R is angle of deviation and R is angle of refraction. Okay. Now, so this is the formula using to find the lateral shape. Next one. Lateral shape in terms of refractive index. This is the neat application. Lateral shift in terms of refractive index. Lateral shift in terms of refractive index. So what is the expression for lateral shift? That is LS is equal to T into sin I minus R divided by cos R. Divided by cos R. This is the expression you need to find the lateral shift for. Okay. So this is in the form of sin A minus B. What is the formula for sin A minus B? Sin A minus B formula. So that is sin A into cos B minus cos B into sin A. Cos A into sin A. So let us use this formula here. At the place of A, I is there, and at the place of B, R is there. Now, let us write T into, so sin A minus of B means sin I minus of R, sin I into cos R, sin I into cos R, minus, next, cos I into sin R, cos I into sin R, into sin R. Whole divided by cos R. Whole divided by cos R. Now, so let us divide each term by cos R. Ili cos R na delse maadutha, so cos R na prati term ne divide maadutha. Now, T into sin R into cos R divided by cos R minus cos R into sin R divided by cos R. Divided by cos R. Then here cos R get cancelled. T into sin R minus cos R into sin R divided by cos R. Divided by cos R. Now, let us write cos R in terms of sin R. How to write cos R in terms of sin R? See. Notice lateral shift of LS is equal to. So LS is equal to. LS is equal to T into sin I minus cos R into sin R divided by cos R. So let us express this cos R in terms of sin R. So LS is equal to T into sin I. Sin I minus cos I into sin R divided by. So cos R can be written as square root of 1 minus sin square R. Square root of 1 minus sin square R. So why it is square root of 1 minus sin square R? See, cos square R plus sin square R, that is equal to 1. But what we need? We need cos R. So that is why I will take sin square R to the right hand side. That becomes minus sin square R. Cos square R is equal to 1 minus sin square R. 1 minus sin square R. Then cos R is equal to square root of 1 minus sin square R. So that is why I written cos R as square root of 1 minus sin square R. Now, so let us use this Snell's law. Using Snell's law. So what is the statement for Snell's law? the ratio of sine of angle of incidence to the sine of angle of refraction, that is equal to constant. That constant is nothing but refractive index. Now sine I divided by sine R, that is equal to mu. That is equal to mu. Means mu is absolute refractive index of the glass. Absolute refractive index of glass means here the refractive index of glass with respect to air. अंदर ग्लास तैयार हो गया, ये मिले मतलब अंदर रिफ्रेक्टिव इंडेक्स ऑफ ग्लास विद रिस्पेक्ट टू ए नाउ सो व्हाट वी नीड साइन आर देन साइन आर इज इक्वल साइन आई बाय म्यू साइन आई बाय म्यू सो लेट अस पुट दिस साइन आर इन दिस इक्वेशन नाउ देन इज इक्वल टू पी इनटू साइन आर माइनस कॉस आर into sin r. So sin r is nothing but here sin I by mu. So I will substitute here. Sin r will be sin I by mu. Then whole divided by 1 minus sorry, square root of 1 minus sin square r. So I will do calculation here. 1 minus of sin square r. So 1 minus of sin r is nothing but sin I by mu. Means it is sin square I divided by mu square. Sin square I divided by mu square, because sin square R is there. Means sin square R is sin square I divided by mu square. Then what is LCM? LCM is mu square. 1 minus of sin square, sorry, mu minus of sin square R. Sorry, sin square r divided by mu square. Divided by mu square. Now, this can be written as square root of mu minus sin square r divided by square root of mu square is mu. Square root of mu square is mu. So, let us substitute the square root of 1 minus sin square r as square root of mu minus sin square r divided by mu in this equation. Now, it is square root of mu minus sin square I divided by mu divided by mu. Then here what get cancelled? 1 by mu get cancelled. 1 by mu get cancelled. Then what remaining? That is equal to the end. So that is LS is equal to T into LS is equal to T into sin I minus cos I into sin I whole divided by square root of mu minus sin square I. Square root of mu minus sin square I. So square root of mu minus sin square r. So sorry, it is mu square. Mu square minus sin square r. Mu square minus sin square r. Then so what is common in these two terms? In these two terms, sin I is common. I will take outside. LS is equal to T into sin I. Sin I is common. Then now 1 minus of cos I whole divided by square root of mu square minus sin square I. So this is the lateral shift in terms of refractive index and angle of incidence. So what is the formula used to find the lateral shift in terms of refractive index and angle of incidence? That is LS is equal to T into sin I 1 minus of cos I divided by square root of mu square minus sin square I. And it is the heat application. Just remember this formula. Then what is T? T is thickness of the slab. What is I? I is angle of incidence. And what is mu? Mu is refractive index of the glass slab. So this is all about the lateral shift.